Welcome to the second of three videos that deal with the transformations of sine and cosine. We just talked about amplitude and period, now we'll talk about horizontal and vertical translations of the sine and cosine functions. So the goals are to determine the horizontal and vertical translations of a sine and cosine function, and then also to graph the sine and cosine functions with these types of translations. Let's start by talking about horizontal translations. The graph of f of x minus d is translated horizontally compared to the graph of f of x. Now this next part can be a little confusing. It says the translation is d units to the right if d is greater than 0, but notice the form is x minus d. So for example, if we're looking at y equals sine of x minus d, since it's minus a positive d, it will be right d units. Secondly, it states the translation is absolute value of d units to the left if d is less than 0. And if d is negative, minus a negative d, it would be x plus d. So again, a little confusing, but if it's in the form of y equals sine of x plus d, it'll be translated d units left. For y equals sine of the quantity x minus pi, this is a horizontal translation, pi units to the right. For y equals cosine of the quantity x plus pi over 3, it'll be pi over 3 units to the left. Now let's talk about a vertical translation. The graph of f of x plus c is translated vertically compared to the graph of f of x. And the translation is c units up if c is positive. And the translation is the absolute value of c units down if c is negative. So if we have the equation y equals sine x plus 1, this will be a vertical shift up 1 unit. Versus if we have y equals cosine x minus 1 half, this will be a vertical shift down 1 half a unit. Let's take a look at an animation that illustrates this. Here we have the graph of y equals sine theta, and the phase shift, or horizontal translation, you can see here, where the graph moves left or right, again, based upon that value of d, and the vertical shift based upon the value of c. So let's go ahead and take a look at a couple examples. Again, remember that d will help us find the horizontal translation or phase shift, and c will help us find the vertical translation. It is assumed that you're familiar with the basic graph of y equals sine theta. So we can see here that our value of d is pi over 4, and our value of c is positive 1. So we have two translations here. So if it's x minus pi over 4, again, we may want to think that's going to be a shift left, but it's actually right pi over 4 unit. And c is plus 1, so the vertical shift is up 1 unit. Remember, the center of the graph y equals sine theta is y equals 0. But if we shift it up 1 unit, the center of the graph will be along this horizontal line instead. Typically, we graph the sine function on the interval from 0 to 2 pi. But since this graph is shifted pi over 4 units to the right, we'll start our graph here at pi over 4. And instead of ending at 2 pi, we'll end one period here at 9 pi over 4. The way I obtained this was I added pi over 4 to 2 pi. So we're going to treat this as the center of the graph. We're going to start it here and end it here for one complete period. And now we're going to use the pattern for the sine function. Remember, the next step is to divide this into 4 equal parts from the previous video. So first we'll divide it in half. This would be 5 pi over 4. And then divide each of these in half. This would be 3 pi over 4. And then divide this in half. And this would be 7 pi over 4. Notice we have 1 pi over 4, 3 pi over 4, 5 pi over 4, and so on. So here's the center of the graph. Remember, our amplitude is still 1. So using these fourths, we'll graph the pattern of the sine function. Remember, sine starts at the center, which in this case will be 1 since it's shifted up 1 unit. Then the next fourth will be up at a maximum. Again, our amplitude is 1, so we'll go up 1 unit for the first fourth, then back down to our center, again down to our minimum now, which 1 unit below our center line would be here, and then back up to 0. So we have our 5 points. We can make a nice graph. And now we have a nice graph over one complete period of y equals sine of the quantity x minus pi over 4 plus 1. If we needed to, we could continue this pattern, but we do have a complete graph over one period. Okay, let's take a look at one more. Here we have y equals negative 1/2 plus cosine of the quantity x plus pi over 2. Again, sometimes I put the constant c in the front, sometimes it's in back. It really doesn't matter. In this case, our c is negative 1/2, therefore the vertical transformation is down 1/2 unit. And the horizontal translation, because it's x plus pi over 2, it's actually going to be left pi over 2 units. Okay, here's the graph of our basic cosine function. We'll use this for reference. First, we typically graph cosine theta from 0 to 2 pi. Since the shift is left pi over 2 units, we'll start our graph at negative pi over 2. Since the period is 2 pi, if we start here and go out 2 pi units, we'll be over here at 3 pi over 2. Next, we'll divide this into 4 equal parts. And since the period is 2 pi, 2 pi divided by 4 will be equal to pi over 2 radians for each fourth. So here we'd be at 0 radians, here we'd be at pi over 2, here we'd be at pi radians, and then lastly 3 pi over 2. So we have this divided into fourths. Next, the center of the graph will no longer be the x-axis since we have a vertical shift down half of a unit. So our new center will be the horizontal line y equals negative 1/2. So we're going to start our function here and end it here. And this will be our center line. Now we'll use the graph of y equals cosine theta for reference. We know typically the cosine function starts at a maximum, and we'll do the same, but our maximum now will be at negative pi over 2. And if we go up 1 unit from negative 1/2, we'll be up at positive 1/2. So again, we've taken what's typically our first point we plot for cosine theta, and we have shifted it left pi over 2 units and down half a unit. The next fourth is at 0, but now it'll be here at negative 1/2 due to the shift. So we start up, we go down. The next fourth is the minimum, so we're going to go down again 1 unit from negative 1/2 to negative 3/2. Next we'll go back up to the center line, the next fourth, and then lastly we end at a maximum. In this case it'll be here at 3 pi over 2. This is enough to make a nice graph of one complete cycle of this function. And there it is. Again, these graphs look very similar. We've just scaled our x-axis and y-axis differently, but the pattern remains consistent. Let's go ahead and take a look at both the parent function and the translated function on the graphing calculator. Check, let's make sure we're in radian mode. Next, we'll set our window from negative pi to 2 pi. With scales of pi over 4. I've already typed in the function to save time. We have the basic cosine function, then we have our given cosine function. Notice the translated function will be the bold function. And so the light graph is our y equals cosine x. Translated function, you can see, has been shifted down half a unit and left pi over 2 units. I hope you found this video helpful. Thank you for watching.